Good morning, everyone. Today we are out in Ballahulish. We're doing the Schoolhouse Ridge and the Complete Horseshoe. With me today is a friend of mine, and he will let you know the names because I can't pronounce any of the Scottish names of the mountain peaks we're visiting today.
Today we are going to be doing Skeorg Dearg and Skeorg Donald.
Going here to the ridge and then all the way up and on top. I will show the rest of the way, then we go. Usually most of the people just do the Schoolhouse Ridge and then come down in the Bilach, I think it's called. So basically the middle way just goes down and then walking back down to Ballahulish. But we had a look at the map and we thought we might go just for the full horseshoe over it. As you can tell, we are pretty early on the run today. We have now almost 7 o'clock. So plenty of time and a great weather forecast. At the beginning, the path is rather unexciting. Just trotting through heather. Slightly boggy, not too bad. But the views are already nicely opening up behind us. Just beautiful. I'll switch you back on later when there's more to see. Step here, nothing too dramatic. Actually, be a nice climb. The rock is with some good steps in it. So usually you can also go, I saw on the other side, but I thought this one is a kind of nicer. Let me see something more from the edge. Brilliant. Another V step. It's really quite an enjoyable V scramble. In German, we actually say kraxeln. And this is like an easy kraxel. Don't know which the scramble grade is. Maybe probably one or the easiest one, I guess. Oh, it's brilliant. A good stone.
One handy fucking helmet. So.
And now, after the, what was it, second or third step, it is quite a bit off. And I think it's the one we see right here. Basically the last bit, but it's really just nice and easy to do. Just always difficult to give the feeling for it, how it looks like here. So. It's a pity. As you can see, that's it basically. But no complaining, this was so fun. And the views are so nice. I mean, a part of it that I can't really pronounce any of the names. And we are now heading just up here. And maybe this is even the peak, or probably a bit later. We are right now at 843 altitude meters. And I think the first one, what is the first one called again?
I'll just tell you the name, let me get the maps right.
You know the one, I will write you here the name, and he's a Munro, so he should be over 1000 meters plus a bit around it. So let us continue.
Stop Dirk.
Sorry. What is it called?
Skurt Dirk.
Skurt Dirk. In my best Scottish. I mean, how is it even possible for a non-Scot to pronounce anything, you know? Okay, let's go. Dirk.
Skurp Dirk.
Skurp Dirk. Ah, beautiful. Not sure if you can make it out, but the path we are following is in here behind it. And it seems to be snow-free. So, all good. This could have been kind of a deal breaker. Depends obviously how much snow it is. And if it's hard or soggy, if we can use crampons or not. But it looks really good. So, the dark one is actually this one, so we still need to walk here all the way around, and I'll switch you back later on. We're approaching the summit of Mil Dirk. So nice. And here we can nicely see. So we didn't come up this one, it was behind, but all the way here, up. And our next one where we are going is down here, over here, the second Munro, and then probably behind it on this ridge in the far back, and then somewhere there down, and then back to Balalulish. Sorry, really, when I pronounced it wrong. So on here is the normal way, which you can take then down to finish off the horseshoe after you have been on the second Munro. We have a look how it looks like from top of the other ridge, if you would miss something, if we do it or not do it. We just looked at it here at the end from the top, and it's much steeper than it looked in the map, but this is usually the case. And here you can see the way maybe a bit better when it goes just down here. And then joining here, the Forest Street Road, or street. Yeah. That's a wee bit uphill. is probably 250 or 300 altimeters. Just by guess, I don't know. And then it should be more or less it's going uphill. This is basically the final ascent, the second Monroe. Such a lovely walk. It's really brain-infused. It's not too much ascent, I think, from altimeters. So far we were 1260, maybe another 80 or something, and then down. So I think it's like between 1300 and 1400 altitude meters. And so far we're in the hike for 7.5 kilometers. Just so nice. We are reaching the top of the other Monroe. It was a really fun hike up here. Maybe even nicer than the Schoolhouse Ridge. Was nice as well, but I don't know. Somehow I enjoyed here the last bit to the second Monroe more. Has some the views up, I think, better. So we have now a look that we've just walked here. Have a look how it looks down there. It's definitely a different way. Something new. Said this, it is also still so early, and to make most of the day. I mean, we are here for walking, so why not walk the longer route? And we are heading now here to the Longer Lochin. You have an advantage to me. Yeah. I can't go underneath, but let's have a look what we can see. It's so amazing how clean the water is up here. I wasn't thinking that at all. I thought this would be a mud puddle or something. And then with this fuse. So and we thought when you can see here the forest, it goes here behind them, it comes down. So this is what we're aiming for. We're just going up here over it, and then maybe we need to come from the side because it's too steep, but we will see. Another Lochen. Looks almost like someone was building here a path over. That's funny. It looks really like that someone was actually putting here all the stones under a purpose. Which I have no idea what the purpose was. When you have an idea, yeah? Would be nice if you would drop me a comment. And we are coming basically from this peak down up this one. Now we walked all the way here, and this is how it looks like in front of us. Holy cow! I think this is the right way to go down. That we go just, we go here over. Over, and then probably here, as we try to cross into here. So this seems to be the beginning of the V Valley, which goes down here. So we'll have a look how steep it is, otherwise we would go here just over this hill and then further down and then crossing a diagonal in, which is probably, would be anyway not a bad idea, but still want to first have a look. But this is not too steep, so probably go down here. I mean, we could also just walk over the side and then come here down and cross it. Let's ask Robert what he thinks. Robert, what do you think? Should we go over and the crossing or just here? Here's steep, and this one is, I think, more relaxed.
Whatever way you go, mate, that's fine. Yeah, I think you're right, okay.
Probably you should go the longer one. Then just let me cross over here. I mean, it's about the walking experience and being outside and not just rushing through. No, I'm not 100% sure the crossing was here or if it was here. So we first have a look here. Not sure. Or down here. It is this one which leads us in. Just the way down. Yep. This was quite a tough walk. All the tree stumps down and the woody bits. Not nice walk, but therefore we are now almost at the street. The tour is basically finished. We are now just going on the forestry road. We are joining the normal school ridge horseshoe, I think. We are just joining it here and then going back to Balahulish. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed our extended version of the schoolhouse ridge and to the Horseshoe Ridge, and when you liked it, hey, leave me a thumbs up or a comment, and see you next time. Bye!